Hello and welcome to Total Health with Dr. Nick, where if you're new to my channel, my purpose is very simple, and that is to inspire, empower, and motivate you to live longer, healthier, and more abundant lives. And today's video is a really great one, especially because everybody wants to get in shape. They want to lose that belly fat, or what's commonly called visceral fat, and we're going to get into what that is in just a moment and why it's so dangerous and why you need to get rid of it. So this video is all about the top 17 tips to lose belly fat. So guys, make sure you watch to the end so you get all the tips. Now, I will tell you, we're not going to go over 17 today. I'm probably going to go over about 10. This is part one of a two-part series, so you want to make sure you tune in and watch for the second video, which will be the next one out. And if you like what we're talking about, make sure you like, you share, you comment, and subscribe. Click that little bell notification so you're notified anytime I do a video so you don't miss a single one. And guys, if you're looking in to get the best shape of your life and you want to lose that belly fat and just get ripped, not only that, just help fight heart disease, cancer, diabetes, any major disease, and you want to know more about the keto diet, check out the link below. I've got my keto course called Ultimate Keto with Dr. Nick. It is by far the best keto course on the entire internet, I promise you. So check that out. Also, too, we've got a great cookbook called the KISS Cookbook. Keto is super simple. That's also in the link below, so check that out, too. Well, let's go ahead and get started on the top 17 best tips to lose belly fat. First of all, what is belly fat? And it's really called visceral fat, and it's a very dangerous kind of fat because anytime you're talking about fat around the midsection, you're talking about fat that surrounds the organs, and that makes it especially dangerous. So visceral fat is really called active fat. So it's the fat stored in a person's abdominal cavity that is known as active fat, and it influences how hormones function in the body. An excess of visceral fat, therefore, can have potentially dangerous side effects. The higher amount of visceral fat a person stores, the more at risk they are for certain health complications. And they are numerous, and they're not just simple ones. These are major health complications that could absolutely destroy or even kill you. So they will shorten your life. You want to make sure that you do not have any of these by making sure you get rid of your belly fat and visceral fat. So what type of health complications are we talking about here? Very serious ones: heart attack, heart disease, blood pressure issues. Guys, I cannot stress enough, when you have visceral fat or belly fat, that means you have fat around your organs, and when you do, it causes a whole host of organic problems that happen in your body. Blood pressure issues, like I said, insulin resistance, type 2 diabetes, and stroke. Not only that, breast and colorectal cancer, Alzheimer's disease, and hormone dysregulation. Because when you start to develop a lot of belly fat, it actually takes on a lot of hormones itself. It starts to produce, like an estrogen factory, more excess estrogen. So this leads to a lot of problems, because a lot of times when you have excess estrogens, you can have all kinds of problems with male issues, but not only that, it can cause cancers. So this is something we definitely want to make sure you get rid of the belly fat. So that's why this video is so important. You want to make sure you watch to the end, because I'm going to be going over all these tips. But like I said, follow up with next week's video, because that's going to be the other tips that we're going to give you. So how do you know if you have visceral fat? Well, very simple. It's going to be carried around the waist. If you look more like an apple, you have visceral fat. So if this is your belt line right here, and you're carrying weight above and below your belt line, and I know a lot of you guys out there are thinking, no, 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 Dr. Nick, I got that. My belt is way up under it. I got that Dunlop disease. No, 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 no. You have belly fat. Even though your belt is well below it, and you got that big old belt buckle down below your gut, you still have belly fat. So don't fool yourself. So if you have it all around the midsection, that's dangerous belly fat, also known as visceral fat. If you have it lower down, where you're carrying it more in your thighs or your butt, that's not as dangerous because it's not surrounding the organs. So good rule of thumb, if you look more like an apple, you're in trouble, and you want to make sure you watch to the end. If you look more like a pear, you're doing a lot better. Still, you need to lose the weight, but you're doing a lot better. So number one tip. Number one is to eat more fiber. Once again, I can't stress it enough. We've known about this for years. Fiber is important because fiber makes up bulk. It fills your body up, and it gives you that feeling of satiety. Not only that, it helps you with your gastrointestinal motility, so you get foods moving through faster. Fiber can help you feel full, stabilize hunger hormones, and reduce calorie absorption from food. A study of over 1,100 adults found that for every 10 gram increase in soluble fiber intake, belly fat gain decreased by 3.7% over a 5-year period. So where do you get your fiber? Well, things like your vegetables, your broccoli, your kale, your spinach cauliflower, asparagus. You could also get it from your berries, and also to things like avocado, peppers, onions. So just make sure you're eating plenty of vegetables and you're going to get all the fiber you need for the day. Next is healthy gut bacteria. Now, for many reasons, I can't stress enough to have healthy microbiome. Microbiome is linked to all kinds of health issues when you have the wrong ratio of good to bad bacteria. Also too, your microbiome is super important for brain function. It's super important for immune system function. So not just belly fat, you want to make sure you have a good healthy gut bacteria for those reasons too. Researchers have found that different types of bacteria play a role in weight regulation, that having the right balance can help you with weight loss, including loss of belly fat. Those shown to reduce belly fat include Lactobacillus fermentum, Lactobacillus amylivoris, and especially Lactobacillus gusseri. So guys, it's important that you have the right probiotics in your gut. Make sure you're getting a selection. Make sure that when you go to the store, you're choosing different Lactobacillus. Make sure you're not getting the same one all the time. You want to have a diverse microbiome. So change brands, change types, change different Lactobacillus. So that way you're getting good diversity. One of the worst things you can have is just the same type of bacteria in your gut. Next is you want to avoid trans fats and bad oils. Now, a lot of times the problem is that you don't know it's bad. You've been duped into TV commercials thinking that all these different fats are good, like, you know, can't believe it's not butter, your shed spreads, things like that. Guys, those are horrible. Industrial oils, you want to avoid those. Things like your canola oil, your Wesson oil, safflower, sunflower, grapeseed oil, all your seed oils. I did a video on this too. Go back and watch that, where I talked about the industrial oils and your vegetable oils. You want to avoid them because you're just not healthy at all. These fats have been linked to inflammation, heart disease, insulin resistance, and abdominal fat gain in observational animal studies. A 6-year study found that monkeys who ate high trans fat diet gained 33% more abdominal fat than those eating a diet high in monounsaturated fats. So switch over to it. You want to make sure that you're eating more monounsaturated fats and more polyunsaturated fats, not from your vegetable oils though. So avoid your trans vegetable oils and your bad oils. In fact, what you really want to do is switch over to coconut oil. Now, I know a lot of you are thinking, coconut oil, that's suntan lotion. I don't put coconut oil. Well, I'm telling you guys, coconut oil has been used for centuries, if not a millennia, by different cultures around the world, and the results and the health benefits are absolutely amazing. You want to use coconut oil. I know you're thinking too, well, maybe it's a saturated fat. I heard it is. It's okay. Saturated fat is good for you. Breast milk is a saturated fat, and that works out pretty well too. So you want saturated fats, you want coconut oil. Coconut oil has MCT oils, which are extremely beneficial at burning fat. MCT means medium chain triglycerides. And like I said, research has been proven that these are extremely beneficial at burning fat, especially abdominal fat. Studies show that medium chain fats in coconut oil may boost metabolism and decrease the amount of fat you store in response to high caloric intake. In one study, men with obesity who took coconut oil daily for 12 weeks lost an average of 1.1 inches from their waists without intentionally changing their diets or exercise routines. So just by changing the type of oils you do, because here's something that most people aren't telling you, that when you use these bad oils, they are toxic to the body. And anytime something's toxic to the body, your body will store fat as an insulator to try to protect you from it. So by switching to a good quality coconut oil, hopefully extra virgin coconut oil, organic, you're gonna be a whole lot better off. So I highly, highly recommend you make this switch. Now, it's gonna taste a little bit coconutty. Sometimes it tastes a little more tropical, but that's okay. I love it anyway, and it goes in a ton of great recipes. In fact, in my cookbook, I use a lot of coconut oil in many of the recipes. Next, eat a lot more fatty fish. I can't stress this enough either, because fatty fish are extremely rich in omega-3s, which are very anti-inflammatory. Not only that, research has shown that it actually helps to reduce belly fat. Studies in adults and children with fatty liver disease show that fish oil supplements can significantly reduce liver and abdominal fat. Now, what are we talking about? We're talking about things like salmon, mackerel, halibut, sardines, anchovies, things like that. All your great fatty fish. Typically, your Mediterranean diet fish are all the best fatty fish to eat. Next, you want to eat more protein. Now, I know a lot of you who are doing the ketogenic diet are thinking, Dr. Nick, What about gluconeogenesis? I'm going to have extra protein. It's going to kick me out of ketosis. Well, I don't want you to worry about that. In fact, I did a video on it where I explain how gluconeogenesis is a demand-driven process, not a supply-driven process. So it doesn't happen just because you have extra protein in your diet and your body's thinking, hey, what are we going to do with this? Let's get rid of it and let's turn it to sugar. That's not how it works. It doesn't kick you out of ketosis. Several studies suggest that people who consume the highest amount of protein are the least likely to have excess belly fat. Now, there's a lot of reasons for this. Sometimes it has to do with the type of hormones that are secreted when you increase your proteins, and sometimes it has to do with the thermic effect of protein. A high protein intake reduces appetite, changes several weight regulating hormones, and boosts your basal metabolic rate. Not only that, okay, like I said, there's something called the thermic effect of foods, and that means that certain foods take more calories to burn. So what that means is that if your calories, say you eat 100 calories of protein, if it takes 30 calories to burn it, that means you have a net calorie increase of just 70. So it's very different with protein compared to other types of foods. Protein has a much higher thermic effect, 20 to 30% compared to carbs, 5 to 10%, and fat about 3%. So that's why you want to include protein, because protein can help actually boost your metabolism, and at the same time it costs calories to burn it, so you have less net calories from it. Now this is an obvious one, obviously reduce carbs. Well, in the ketogenic diet, that's what you do. Not so much on, say, the paleo diet or other diets, but on the ketogenic diet, you're going to take in less carbs. In fact, the ketogenic diet is typically high fat, moderate protein, low carbs. Reducing your carb intake can be very beneficial for losing fat, including abdominal fat. Diets under 50 grams of carbs per day cause belly fat loss in people who are overweight, those at risk for type 2 diabetes, and women with polycystic ovarian syndrome. So why is that? Well, very simple. When your body has less calories coming in from carbs, so you take in, say, less than 50, which is a huge reduction from your standard American diet, or what I call the SAD diet, which you might have 100, 200, or 300 grams of carbs. When you take in just 50, your body's forced to turn to fat for fuel. And when it does that, it's going to start to burn that belly fat. So as long as you don't keep spiking your insulin and spiking your blood sugar, you're going to be able to lose that belly fat because your body will turn to fat for fuel. The next thing is to reduce sugary foods, juices, and beverages. This is something you definitely want to avoid because you don't want to take in your calories in liquid form. It is not good for the body because you fool the body. It's so rich in sugar, yet you're not getting the fiber. So if you're having a glass of orange juice, you're thinking, but Dr. Nick, this is made by God. This is good. I can have this. That's not really the case, because what happens is that fiber is not present to slow down the absorption of the sugar, but not only that, it's not there to offset the sugar. All you're getting is a big tall glass of sugar water, so you don't want to do that. Not very beneficial. So liquid calories do not make you feel full. That's another thing. You're not going to feel full without the fiber, so you're just getting sugar blasted into your system. In a controlled 10-week study, overweight and obese people who consume 25% of calories from fructose-sweetened beverages on a weight-maintaining diet experienced a decrease in insulin sensitivity and an increase in belly fat. So guys, this is how we see this insulin resistance. We're eating too many processed refined carbs. It's causing our insulin to become spiked so much that our body doesn't even hear it anymore. You become insulin resistant. It's almost like, you know, after a while you're knocking at the door and you're not even hearing a knocking anymore. So the problem is that when you keep spiking your blood sugar too much, spiking your insulin, eventually you become insulin resistant. And last but not least, alcohol. But don't turn this off. You stay on this channel. Don't go anywhere. I know you're thinking, Dr. Nick, you just crossed the line. I need my alcohol. That's my little helper. Listen, guys and gals. You don't need as much alcohol, okay? Trust me on that. Alcohol is going to become a big problem for you, not just for obvious reasons, but because it also puts on weight around the belly. One thing you have to realize is that depending on the type of alcohol you're drinking, and I did a video on this too, your body switches. It looks at it like a triage. It says, okay, what's the most important thing to do right now? I have to neutralize the alcohol. That's more important than burning fat, okay? So your liver stops burning fat and just neutralize the alcohol. So you don't want that to happen. One study found that men who consume more than 3 drinks per day were 80% more likely to have excess belly fat than men who consumed less alcohol. So guys, you don't want that beer gut. I know some of you think it's pretty cute, but it's not. Once again, anytime you have that beer belly, you have more visceral fat. Visceral fat leads to a whole host of those health issues I was telling you about, from heart disease, diabetes, insulin resistance, hormone dysregulation, everything you can imagine. Another study involving more than 2,000 people showed that those who drank alcohol daily but averaged less than one drink per day had less belly fat than those who drank less frequently but consumed more alcohol in the days they did drink. So that's pretty interesting. So even the people who drank a little bit each day but drank less each day, they had less belly fat than the ones who didn't drink every single day, but when they did, they went at it. They had a lot more. So that's a pretty interesting study. So anyway, guys, this is part one, like I said, of two parts. You want to make sure you see the second part. And like I said, make sure you like, you share, you comment, and subscribe. Click that little bell notification. And before you go, make sure you check out my other videos. If you like this video, you're going to love those too. Trust me on that. Well, anyway, this is Dr. Nick. I love and appreciate you. Have a blessed day, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.